Hey guys, I wanted to do a hopefully quick video on how I create my own chemicals for the gardyn system. I don't use any of their products, and I've had pretty good success. I actually bought another unit that I'm trying to grow flowers for the front yard, so they're coming in. And what I'll mix today is a solution for that, because they're just starting to sprout. I see some true leaves, and so I'm gonna add for the first time some fertilizer, and I'll show you how to do it, and maybe you guys could save some money using this tip. So these are the chemicals that I use to create the fertilizer. I use the miracleGro flower flue, the bloom formula. And then I'm recently switched from, this is all Home Depot stuff, so this Black Magic CalMag, I've been using that, but I recently stopped using that and just went straight with Epsom salt, hydrogen peroxide, pH up and pH down. So it looks like a lot of stuff, but it's really a lot simpler and cheaper. The main thing that you guys should have, no matter what, is some kind of meter to check your pH level and your EC. You hear guys talk about EC. I never really understood it, but looking at a bunch of hydroponic videos, if you have an EC somewhere around 2000, which means when you mix all this stuff in there and you dip this in there and the number on the screen comes up to be around 2000 and the pH is at 6, then that's going to be a safe number for pretty much whatever you have in your system. First thing I have is I keep a little aquarium pump in the tank. It adds aeration to the water and it seems to keep it very clean. It's quiet. So when I'm making my solution, I just plop it in. It's a plain bucket of water, 5 gallons. I always start with to see where I'm at. So this is at 5.7 pH and the EC is at 480. So if I was making the solution for the full grown plants, I would create a 2000 EC solution. Since these are young seedlings, I'm just gonna drop it back to maybe 1500 or 1600. So first thing I do is, this is Epsom salt, about 10 teaspoons of salt, and warm water, let it dissolve. And then when you pour it in, you see the EC change. So I want this EC, since I'm only going to 1600, I just want the EC to maybe be around 800. And these are just numbers that I'm pulling out of my head. You know, I say half with that and half with this. So when I add this, a little bit at a time, let the pump stir it around a little bit, doesn't take long. So now my EC is like 480. So I'll add a little more. And the reason you want one of these, even if you're not gonna make your own solution, the gardenia or garden chemicals, they give you a ballpark on what to add, but if you wanna know exactly where you're at and make sure you're not killing your plants, because I see a lot of people say, why is this dying? And a lot of it is the water quality. So right now I am at 750, which that's probably good. I'm gonna leave it right there. So now I'm gonna add plant food. And again, this is just miracleGro. And I'm gonna try and get the solution to 1500 or 1600. So I just poured a little bit in. Doesn't matter how much you add to these because you're using your meter to check the water quality. But my pH is down to 5.8, so I'm just gonna bump it up a little bit with, this is Home Depot's pH up, and shake it up a little bit. Doesn't take much. And now I'll let the pump start around a little bit. Now, right at 6, and my EC is almost 13. I'll make it a little higher. Compared to the gardenia stuff, this is pennies on the dollar. It's really cheap. So now I'm at 1500 and 6.0. I'm done. That's my solution. So that's all I do. Had pretty good success with the vegetables. Hoping to have just as much success with the flowers. And I am not a member. I don't do Kelby. I think it's too expensive. And I don't buy their chemicals because I think it's too expensive. And I don't buy their seeds because I think it's too expensive. So these are all seeds that I've planted. Some of these are, most of these are with the starter kit, and the lettuce is great. I think the arugula is bitter. I think a lot of this stuff doesn't taste good. So I'm gonna do seeds for spinach and some other vegetables and hopefully have good success with that. So hopefully this helps you guys. Thanks.